It is 9:18 p.m., which means it is time for your daily dose of acid games. So I literally can't. Okay. That's weird. So I found out where the last Miss Warp was. And by found out, I mean I looked it up. I literally could not figure this out on my own. I was running all around. And when I say I looked it up, that sounds like it was super easy. It wasn't. Trust me. That's where it was. It was in that freaking question mark block this entire time. And I've been running around like a lunatic, losing lives like crazy. But anyway, that's where it was. There's no guides, really, for this. Like, seriously. You would think that something like that, like a Miss Warp, would be really... Yeah, no, that just doesn't work. Alright. You would think that would be really easy to find, right? Like, that's one of the two or three things that you can even collect in this game. But all you have, as far as walkthroughs go, that I could find at least, were people getting all melons, which is cool, but there's no melons over there, so they would never go over there and get that Miss Warp. Or people going for all the hearts, or both. But because that Miss Warp was just out of the way like that, people never went for it. So yeah, it was extremely difficult to find, completely unnecessarily. And I have wasted so many lives trying to get it, but it is finally done. I have completed the deed. All of the things have been found. And as much as I totally could, like, I guess I could go find a melon if I really felt like it. But I don't really feel like it. So I'm just gonna freaking take this apple. Because good enough for me. On my last life, hopefully I'll be able to beat the boss in one go. Here it is. Do 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 do. Baby bows. Dup, 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 dup. This is a little song. Dup, 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 dup. Anyways, what have we here? Oh, wait, that is not his voice.
What have we here?
That is definitely also not his voice. You know what? Artistic license, right?
What have we here? Mario's our pet. I have pets, too. Let's all play together. Play nice, you wimpy pet. I hate guests who throw bob-ombs at my ceiling.
I mean, thanks for letting me know. Oh god, there's spooky ghosts. Ah, they're throwing lava at me. Which is not cool. What if I throw... Oh, okay. That was cool. Hi-ya. Come back. Come at me, bro. See if I care. Okay, I can't... Come at me, bro. Oh no, there's a bomb. Whew. You have to throw them at the ceiling, and you have to do so before they explode. Because otherwise they will explode. Ta-da! Got him again. Loser! Yeah, that's right, I've hit you twice now. Get out of here. Bro, what are you even doing down here? Good thing this boss fight is not terribly difficult. Because if it was like a hard boss fight, I would be so screwed. And so unhappy. Okay. Apparently, once I've done that, they don't explode, so that's nice. Come on. Hey-ya. How about that? Hell yeah. And I did it. Well, that was easy.
Here's my...
Oh, God, that voice.
Here's my poem. I'm the king, you dino guy. I'll smash you now, so say goodbye.
Oh, that wasn't the end. Oh, okay.
Ow.
I want the invincibility heart. Give me the invincibility heart. Ow. I said the invincibility heart. Not all that other stuff. Okay. Yeah, get out of here, boy. Okay. And there he goes. Heck yeah. And I have infinite eggs, so screw you. Okay, never mind. That doesn't seem to be really working at all. Eh. Okay, this was a... Oh, okay, I got him. I just got to hit him from the front, not the back. Got him again, I guess? Oh. What's up? Just sort of had a stare down there. Hiya! Heck yeah. Death to Baby Bowser. This is actually Baby Bowser, by the way. Not Bowser Jr. This is just Bowser when he was young, getting his butt kicked by Yoshi's.
Yeah, this hurts. I hate you, puny little Yoshis. I'll give you back your super stupid tree.
Wow. That stings, baby Bowser. That really hurts me deep. Inside.
Besides, its fruits taste rotten to me.
It's because you don't have the happiness inside. That's what this game's about. Do I get my Yoshis back? No. They're just flying baby Bowser away from the castle. So I guess all my Yoshis that are in the castle are free now, simply by the fact that I'm the master of the castle. I can't believe I beat that on the last life. Crap was dangerous. I feel kind of bad that I, like, looked it up. I really wish I had been able to beat it with that, but I didn't look up the locations of the hearts, and to be fair, I had literally been in that location. I just didn't... I should have known, because when I tried to push it up the slope, it didn't work. But... What a great score! Ah, I get to enter my name? Well, no more QWERTY here. This one. Oh, I did two caps. Well, too late now. Oh, I can do Japanese? Bro. Heck yeah. Oh, God. Alright, testing my knowledge here. Where's my she? Think that's she? It's really hard to read in this format. No, that's not she. She's the one with the sideways ones. Japanese lessons, my dudes. Oh, wait. Maybe that is she. This one's she. Here we go. Ashi. I shouldn't do another E. That would be weird. Ashido. Where is the do? Oh. It's toe. And then... Yeah. That's great. I don't know why they gave me that option, but they did. Ashido. Ashido? There's no s. Ashido? Whatever, good enough. Ashido. That's what that said. And that's our first run through of Yoshi's Story. Is it gonna finish the tale, or are you just gonna rain? Oh, here we go. This is the full story, my dudes. And so the adventure began. The Yoshi set out to find the super happy tree. Poochie the dog helped. Oh, this is literally just the... This is the story that... Not even Elf. Yeah, we already read this. So they're just telling us the story again, but in order. That seems really silly. Can I, like, skip this? We've already read all of this. Oh, I guess they're not doing the page turn could be happier part at least. To avoid a dark, scary cave, the Yoshis entered a nearby tunnel. I'm gonna read this in Blarg's voice down there. That's a Blarg down in the middle.
Inside, they found a maze that overflowed with running water. I'm happy. Perhaps they should have gone through the cave instead. Visited Blarg. Blarg is lonely.
It's okay, Blarg. I'll visit you next time. Maybe.
As the Yoshis were walking, they found a trail of clouds that led to the sky. The Yoshis were afraid of falling, but they walked on the clouds anyway, because they were badasses. Up in the sky, they met Cloud and Candy, who was mean but tasted sweet. They consumed him whole. He's still inside their stomachs to this day, screaming in eternal pain and torment.
Strange creatures come out at night, and in the jungle, it was always dark.
Once again, that's terrifying. What if you just read this story to kids? Like, what if you just went up to your son and or daughter and was like, here you go, I'm gonna read you a bedtime story. It's a story of the Yoshis. They crawled through a jungle. They almost died several times. Literally just played this level.
To go any farther, the Yoshis had to brave the ocean. They jumped in and then drowned and died. They like to swim, but the jellyfish's sting spoiled their fun.
Like, would your kid enjoy this? Your kid would enjoy the music, I guarantee that. They swam to dry land. Now they're almost to the end of the book. And that's when all the good stuff happens. Oh, I haven't actually...
The Yoshis found the castle and figured the super happy tree was there. They just sort of assumed that. Instead, they found hot lava and a hot-tempered baby Bowser.
It was hot. At least there was lava in that level. That was nice.
But happiness wins in the end, and the Yoshis paddled?
Like they spanked him? That seems like an awkward bit of thing there.
All's well that ends well. The Yoshis had broken Bowser's spell. The super happy tree was back. They jumped for joy with their fruity snack.
You're a fruity snack. Wink.
And the Yoshis live happily ever after. Until you start the game again, and then they're going to be unhappy again, and then the tree will be stolen again, and we'll just start this whole process over.
Happy end. Is this like a dating sim? Could I have gotten bad end? Is that an option? I certainly hope not.
Yay.
Aw, what a great story. What a great story that had a really awkward anticlimactic end of me searching for that Ms. Warp. But it's fine. I found it in the end. That's what matters. I've learned that I shouldn't sing, especially when I'm playing these really low-res games, or like really, because they're going through a converter and also going through my Game Capture HD, so it makes the synchronization super off. So if I sing, it just sounds like I'm singing like two beats off, which is really obnoxious to listen to. Do we have to watch the credits? Do we have to watch the credits? We have to watch the credits. Thank you, Terry Munson, for making this game readable. And Phil Sandhop. That's a great name. Hopping in the sand all day long. There's a person whose name is Shin. It's actually Sheen, but Greg Von Oy. That's a great name. Man, I loved when credits were this short. Like, that was nothing. That took literally less than a minute. That was like 20 seconds of credits. Wow, look at all those QWERTYs. They're so bad at this game. Just kidding. I'm not doing a melon run. Maybe I'll do that on my own time, but wow, that would be terrible. I watched some people do it. It's there's a lot going on there. Wait, do I have to like reset the console? The N64 did that sometimes. I can't get off this. Yes, thank you. I'm glad that my story ranking is what it is. Well, guess that's that. Guess I just have to reset. So that's cool. And on your next dose of acid games, Ashido will be back to try to beat that high score. Not really, mostly just trying to beat all the levels. And I will see you all then. Bye.